Hey everyone, my name is Kylie and this is Miss Kyla Reads, and today I am going to be reviewing a book for you, Shawman's Crossing, the first book in the Soldier's Son trilogy by Robin Hobb. Boy, that was a mouthful. This book was first published in 2006 by Harper Voyager and had 591 pages mass market paperback. Now, if you were like me and you thought that Robin Hobb only wrote books in the Elderling realm, no, do not think that, because she has this other trilogy named the Soldier's Son trilogy, and it is fantastic. At least the first book is at least. What? This is the first book in a fantasy trilogy that is very military focused. We follow a young boy named Navarre, and from birth, he knows that he is destined to be a soldier because he is the second son of a nobleman. And second sons are always soldiers, so Navarre knows what he's going to be from birth. Now, Navarre's father was also a second son of a noble, but he fought in the war and the king appointed him a new noble out in the frontier. So now Navarre's father is a noble, so Navarre is the second son of a noble, so he is supposed to be a soldier. Navarre goes to a military school named the Kavala Academy, the King's Academy, and he goes to school there to learn how to be in the Kavala. And there is an obvious divide between the old nobles, like Navarre's father used to be, and the new nobles, which Navarre's father is a new noble, and there is an obvious divide between those two sections, and that reflects what's actually happening in the greater world, and that was just really awesome. Eventually, Navarre will work for the king in the military, and the king is trying to build the king's road eastward through the frontier, and that needs to go through the forest of this savage people, or the forest people, that is their territory, so they need to be able to go through their territory in order to keep building this road. Navarre gets involved in this forest people's magic, and it threatens to rip his soul in two. That's the basic gist of this book, I think. So my main review of this book was, it was fantastic. Simple as that. It was such a great character-focused story with awesome world-building and fantastic writing, and that's the three things you need right there. I felt like the concept that you are born into your role very interesting. Like, the first son of a noble is going to be the heir, so he learns how to bring up the estate and how to run the estate and how to marry off his daughters so they can have good marriages and stuff. And the second son is destined to be a soldier and join the king's military. And the third son is destined to become a priest. So they only learn those things when they're growing up. They don't learn any other things besides what they're destined for. I think this story could have very easily turned into a story where Navarre is born to be a soldier, but he actually really wants to be a priest or something like that. So there would be that conflict between him, but no, that's not what this was. Navarre knows he's going to be a soldier. He feels it in his heart. The good God destined him to be a soldier, so that's what he's gonna be. And I think that also could have led into Navarre being a super soldier, you know, such a good soldier. But no, he has doubts about himself. He doesn't think that he's the best soldier. He doesn't even know if he's going to be able to lead soldiers one day. So I think he is a very solid main character. This story is not action-packed. In this first story, we don't have battles or anything like that. Navarre is just going to military school. That's basically it. So it is not action-packed, but I found it so intense at parts. I found it so heart-wrenching and nerve-wracking, and that is crazy because I usually feel those things like during battle scenes of epic books. But no, this was just small little things that were causing me to feel that much, and that is great. I also loved the hierarchy in this book because it was so well explained. You have the king, and then you have the old nobles who live around the king, and their soldier sons went out into the world and fought in the battle, and the king raised some of those soldier sons up to be nobles. So now they are at the same level as the old nobles, and their sons are both going to military school together, and the old nobles feel like they are so much more better and privileged than the new noble sons. And it's just a great dynamic, and I loved how thoroughly explained it was. I don't think I'm doing a good job of explaining it right now, but when you read the book, it is so well thought out and explained, and it's just great. The magic in this book is mysterious and forbidden, and I really liked that. It's kind of based on folklore and fairy tales, kind of the forest people, And it's just great. I feel like it is what Patrick Rothfuss would classify as poetic magic, because we don't really understand how it works, but it's there, so we get to see it, but even if we don't know how it works. So let's move on to the characters. I thought the characters were so great. They were so well thought out, and no character was just one-dimensional. I felt like every single character, no matter if we saw them a lot or a little, was so much more dynamic than some characters that I've read about. We read this story from first person from Nevers' perspective. And like I've talked about, Nevers is a character who has doubts about himself. He doesn't know if he's going to be able to lead, and he doesn't want to let his father down, and he doesn't really know what's morally correct at the academy because he sees people that are doing things that are immoral. So I like that he is such a relatable character, because that is what I would feel like at school. If people were doing something that I didn't think was right, I wouldn't say anything because I'm like, okay, they must be getting away with it if nobody is saying anything. And it's just like those little tiny things, you know, that just make it so realistic. The different boys that are in his troop at the academy, there was 12 of them to begin with, and so they got a little confusing for me, but then as they kind of pared down, I really liked Spink, who was Nevers' best friend. I really liked his character because he was very set in his morals, and he knew this was right and this was wrong and there was no room in between. And then I also liked Gord, who was a character that knew how to lead in a silent way. And I really liked his character as well. And some of the boys I just hated so much. Like the colonel of the school, who was basically like the principal, his name was Colonel Stite. Whatever. And his son's name was Calder. And although Calder is like 12 years old and all of the boys going to military school are at least 18 years old, Calder tries to fit in with them, and he does that by being a tattletale and by being a snarky little shit. And I hated both of those people. I literally wanted to strangle them both throughout the entire book because they were just so stupid. But I can see them in reality being those type of people, you know? Like, it wasn't so far-fetched. Like, ugh. So I have to applaud Robin Hobb for making hateable characters, because seriously. Ugh. So overall, this book just felt so real for me, and I don't think I've felt that with a book in a long time. Like, I could mentally and vividly picture them in my mind, and it was just great. I just got so immersed in this world, and I just haven't felt like that in such a long time. I think this was a fantastic setup for a trilogy, and I cannot wait to get to the second book. I actually have started the second book because as soon as I finished Shawman's Crossing last night, I was like, I need to download the second book so I can read it. Overall, I didn't find anything at fault with this book. Like, I can't think of one thing that I didn't like about this book or that I thought needed to be changed, because it was just awesome. It was a really solid fantasy read. In conclusion, read the book. I never thought that I would like a military-focused fantasy, and if you feel like that, don't be discouraged, because this was really easy to get into, and I enjoyed it thoroughly. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars because it was that awesome, and I think you should read it if this video has interest you whatsoever. All right, everyone, those were my thoughts on Shawman's Crossing, the first book in the Soldier's Son trilogy by Robin Hobb. Comment down below if you have read this trilogy and how great the second and third books are, because I have really high hopes for them. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and until next time, goodbye!